So I have my user data up at the top. Down at the bottom is a filter that I've done already. So the first thing you're going to see, there's no little arrow with the drop down for the boxes that contain different ways to filter and sort if you're using a filter in Excel. And it's also just done in this cell E9. So if I delete E9, E10 is a function of that, even though it looks like it's just a 2 is typed in. So I'll delete E9, hit enter, and then E10 goes away also because that was part of that, a result of the formula. There's two ways to get this going. The one is to press the F with a little X, it's a function button, and then you'll get a list of all the functions. Filters at the top just because I used it recently, but you would find it by down, it's an alphabetical order, press filter, and then you select filter here. So all that does, it pre-populates your formula box with the word filter. Now we're going to tell it what the range is. First, we're just going to do it on the first column. So let's do E4 colon E6. So that's saying, hey, Google Sheets, I want to filter the data that's in E4 to E6, which is also shown by this red rectangle. So now that you're working on a tablet, you can actually, this is dangerous because it sometimes misbehaves for me, but if I take my finger, obviously you can't see my finger, but you can see my, there's no mouse, and hold down the red circle in the lower right-hand corner of the rectangle, I think I can drag this to the right. Yeah, and that automatically changed my range, much like you would use a mouse. But I'm going to drag it back. We're just going to do it on that. And then I'm going to do a comma. So the condition is, let's say I want to filter it for everything that's greater than 1. You got to retype the range so it knows where you're operating on. So that range greater than 1. And I'm done. I'm going to hit enter. Oh, awesome. See why they didn't that work. Not sure why that didn't work. Let me delete it, redo it. Equals filter. So that I'm actually, by virtue of that not working, I'm just gonna show you the second way, which is just to type it. So the range again is E4 to E6. And let's say the condition is that E4 to E6 greater than 1. Done. Enter. Yeah, it decided to work that time. You're watching the video, you could probably tell what I did wrong. Right now, I'm not sure. So, but that's a filter, simple filter on one set of data, one column. So let's see what we want to do for two columns. I'm going to delete this in E9. It's also going to delete E10 because that was a result of what was in E9. Or not. Let's say right now, let me delete it. So here I'm going to do filter, and I'm going to say on E4 all the way over to F6, and my condition here is going to be if F4 to F6 is equal to AA. Hit enter, and it should give me, before I hit enter, here's what I would expect. I would expect, since I'm doing the entire, since I'm doing both columns, I want the result to contain both columns. But I'm just using the, applying the criteria to column F. So it's going to do which ones match column F, but give me both columns. And I can see right now as I'm talking that I want a single A. So now that that's fixed, I'm going to hit enter. And voila, I think that's what we expected, so that's good. Let's do one more thing. Let's do multiple criteria. I'm gonna come back into this formula and I'm gonna say condition 2, multiple conditions. And this one I'm gonna say E4 to E6, maybe. E4, E6 equal to 2. And I don't need the quotes because 2 is a numerical value. You need the quotes on text. That's why the quotes are around the 8. So I'm going to hit enter. It should live redo this, kind of in the same way as if you were clicking the drop-down menus on a filter function on a desktop or laptop. There we go. It redid it live, and really it only changed the formula in E9. If you look in F9, there is no formula. Reset little 2 popped up there again. I don't know why that's popping up again. I'm gonna delete it. So that's an overview of the filter function. It's there, it works. I don't think it's nearly as useful as doing it on a desktop, because on a desktop, a lot of times you wanna look at things on the fly. That's why you use filters. So I just click it and I click A, and then I click the other header and I click BB, and then I would undo them. And that's a lot clunkier to do when you're typing it in. But that's the state of Google mobile sheets right now.